Hi students, now we are into the next lecture of nuclear chemistry. Okay, we are into the next lecture of nuclear chemistry. We have completed almost how many lectures? Three lectures. Okay, we have completed our three lectures. Okay, so three lectures. Now we are going to start with the fourth lecture. Okay, so if you are not attended any first, second or third, then it is very bad. Okay, you will not be able to understand, because lecture 1 was everything about the basics. Okay, specially we focused on the nucleus. Okay, and terms used, because this terms used is going to affect you when you study further. In this lecture I am going to use it, and I will tell you also where I explained. Okay, then lecture 2 is basically about the, so lecture 2 is about the stability of nucleus. Okay, stability of nucleus. Okay, in terms of the n by p ratio, in terms of what? N by p ratio. As well as, apart from that stability of nucleus, we have discussed the radioactivity reason, cause of radioactivity. Okay, in lecture 3 we have discussed about the alpha, beta and gamma. Now in the lecture 4, where you are here, in this lecture we are going to study about the theory of disintegration. Okay, what is the topic of the day? This is the theory of disintegration. Okay, in this lecture 4 is theory of nuclear disintegration, where you will be discuss the complete theory in 4 points. In how many points? In 4 points. So don't forget to watch up to the last, and 4th point is very important because it is used in the numerical. 4th point I have divided further into how many parts? 4 parts. Okay, each and every part. This is what the, our lecture plan of the day. Understood? In lecture 4, what we are going to study? Theory of nuclear disintegration. How many points? 4 points. 4th point is further divided into 4 points. Okay, so watch it till last, and give it a like and make a notes. Is it understood? Okay, so let's start with the next screen. Okay students, now we are going to start with the next topic, next lecture, that is theory of nuclear disintegration, theory of nuclear integration, and it is given by Rutherford. It is given by Rutherford and Soddy. Okay, already in the atomic structure also, atomic structure model was, the model of atomic structure was given by, was successfully given by what? Rutherford only. But he was able to explain in that only, in the limitation itself, we have studied that, in the limitation itself, we have studied that Rutherford model was successful in explaining about the nucleus, but it could not explain about the extra nuclear part. Okay. So that, from that we can understand he was successful in nucleus. That's why his points are more interested, more accurate, more applicable for the nucleus. Okay, so he, apart from the atomic model, he also gave theory of nuclear integration. Okay, so like in every theory there will be postulates. Okay, so here postulates are there, we take the excited atom. Okay, an atom in excited state. But as it is a nuclear chemistry, what we are going to do here, we are talking about, we are going to discuss more about the nucleus. Here, as a atom, we say excited state. Atom is excited state means electrons are having more energy than the required energy. Okay. Once we say an atom is in excited state, that is with respect to what? Electron. So once we say excited nucleus, that means in terms of the binding energy. okay, in terms of the binding energy or higher energy level. Okay, so energy level of the energy is more, otherwise binding energy is less, then we say excited state. Nucleus is in the excited state, and stability rules are same. Like atom in excited state cannot stay for a longer time, it will emit some electromagnetic waves. Okay, in case of the atom, what are the waves emitted? Electromagnetic waves, where we studied about the, what we studied about the atomic spectrum, hydrogen spectrum we have studied. Depending on the energy, they will be divided into different parts. Okay, so here this energy is not emitted in form of the electromagnetic wave. Okay, different similarity is that both atom and nucleus in excited state, both are unstable. But the way of getting stabilization is different in different condition. In atom, it gets stabilized by, it gets back to ground state by emission of the electromagnetic waves. Okay, but here it gets stabilized. But in this case, what it happens, it gets stabilized by radioactivity. Okay, so lower energy and higher energy. Higher energy is not only the option, there is another option, bonding energy, binding energy also low. Okay, what is that binding energy? That you will get in another lecture. Okay, you can follow that. Then what is the importance of the binding energy? With the binding energy, what we can come to know, there is separate lecture for that. In that lecture you will understand binding energy. Okay, for the time being you should understand high energy of nucleus corresponds to low binding energy. Okay, so it is in excited state, excited state unstable. So to lower the energy, lower energy means stability higher. So to decrease the energy, to increase the stability of an nucleus in excited state, it loses what? Alpha particle. From where it will lose? It will lose from the nucleus. Okay, so it will lose from the nucleus as a energy. That means if an alpha particle is loosed, that means energy will decreases. Energy decreases, hence what happens? Binding energy increases and energy level decreases. All will happen part-wise, simultaneously. Okay, so when an alpha particle is emitted, two things happens. What is that? Binding energy improves as well as energy levels decrease. Energy also, energy carrier, that means energy is carried away from the nucleus. Okay, okay, energy will be carried away from the nucleus. The first point, is it clear? An atom in excited state. Excited state means two meanings: low binding energy, high energy levels, and to attain lower energy or increase stability, it loses alpha particle, which act as an energy carrier. Energy will be carried from the nucleus to outside the nucleus. Okay. Okay, this is the next point, during alpha decay. Okay, so whatever we have studied after the alpha, beta, gamma, that is only we are continuing. Okay, so you can write after that only alpha. In the previous lecture, what we have studied about the alpha, beta and gamma. Okay, so after that alpha, beta, gamma, you can write this, you can write everything regarding these values. Understood? So during alpha decay, energy decreases, but N by P ratio increases. It was clearly told with an example in the second lecture, I think. Second or third lecture I have mentioned. So I have mentioned that N by P ratio increases when alpha particles decay. The steps to increase N by P ratio, the steps to decrease N by P ratio, what are the measures, that I have explained in the second lecture. Okay, so for clarity, what you can do, you can go through that lecture if you have not gone through till now. Okay, what is the speciality of N by P ratio and how it is used for stability. It was explained in the second lecture of N by P ratio. Okay, so here alpha ray causes one good thing is that energy is decreased, which is required for increasing in. Energy is decreased, which is good for the increasing in what? Increasing in stability. But there is one problem also. What is that problem? N by P ratio also increases. Okay. But some people, some elements, some nucleus wants to increase. For them, it is not a problem. But in some cases, what is the problem is that they wanted to decrease the N by P ratio also, decrease the energy also. Then what they will do? Hence to decrease the N by P ratio. Hence to decrease the N by P ratio and attain stability, nucleus after the alpha particle. Clearly I told you alpha plus beta will not happen. Alpha after alpha beta can come. Alpha and beta cannot come. Understood? So beta, if you wanted to make a beta, what is the beta? Beta is simply minus one charge. How a nucleus can form minus one charge? That is possible due to the neutron transformation. Okay, what is that neutron transformation? So one nucleus, neutron available inside the nucleus, converted into proton and electron. Okay, so that extra energy will be released as a neutrino. What is this neutrino? Understood? So beta particle, question will be how beta particle can come from the nucleus. What should be the reason? The reason is transformation of neutron. Transformation of what? Neutron into proton and electron. A proton can convert in, so neutron can convert into proton and electron. Okay. A neutron can convert into proton and electron. But here we will not say as electron, because Thomson's model, uncertainty model says that electron cannot exist in the nucleus. Now we call this electron as a beta emission. Understood? So if an atom, if an atom A, this I think everybody noted this. So if you have noted, then I will try to explain with the equation. Okay. This is the second point, and further explaining I am here. So N by P ratio theory is very important. Go through that lecture if you are not done. Okay. So suppose an element A is there. Okay. N by P ratio is already high and it wanted to decrease. What it will do? It will first undergo alpha, then followed by beta. Okay. If N by P is already low, then if it wanted to increase the N by P ratio, okay, then it will undergo only alpha emission. Understood? Okay, so A is giving the N by P ratio, higher N by P ratio, lower N by P ratio. Okay, if N by P ratio is higher than the stability, to decrease the N by P ratio, first it have to emit the alpha, because to decrease the energy. But again, to decrease the N by P ratio, it has to go for the beta emission also. Okay, that's why an atom may not be able to attain stability by single emission. Okay, it cannot be stable by the single emission. And A, when already N by P ratio is low, then only alpha emission is sufficient, because it also reduces the energy, also increases the N by P ratio, which is required here. Understood? So whether this will go this side or it will go like this, that depends upon the N by P ratio. Okay, that's why some particle loses only alpha particle, some particle loses only beta particle, some particle loses alpha and beta. Okay. Okay, here this neutron. This neutron is converted into one proton plus one electron, and this energy is less than the total energy available. That's why this is called as an anti-neutrino. What it is called as? Anti-neutrino. Okay, this is called anti-neutrino. Anti-neutrino is used for explaining the energy compensation from left side to the right side. Okay, just make a note of the second point, then we will go to the next point. Okay, after the second point, we are into the third point. Actually, I forgot to write this theory of nucleus disintegration. It is not integration. It is the theory of nuclear disintegration. It is given by Rutherford and as well as another scientist, Soddy. Okay. So, we have discussed the two points in the third point. There are actually two types of emissions. Primary emission. Okay. First one is called as primary emission. Next one is called as secondary emission. Okay. Primary emission and secondary emission. So, primary emission is just emission of alpha and beta. Emission of alpha particle and beta particle. If the energy is sufficiently reduced as per the requirement, then the reaction will stop then and there. These are minimum required. That's why they are called as a primary emission. Okay. So, third point of the nuclear theory of nuclear disintegration is that the radioactive emissions by a unstable nucleus are divided into two types. First will be primary emission. They are must and they are first also. Must and first. Okay. So, they will be emitted first and they are very very required for converting unstable nucleus to stable nucleus. Whereas secondary emissions are not compulsory. Even after the loss of alpha particle or beta particle, still some energy is to be lost. If some still energy is to be lost, then only this emission will take place, that is gamma emission. Okay. Secondary emission are account for the gamma emission, primary emission account for the alpha and beta. Okay. And suppose after losing the alpha particle, still some more energy is more. Then secondary emission. After emission of alpha particle, energy need not to lose, already stabilized because of the less energy, then this will not be there. Same way beta emission, it is becoming stable by losing the sufficient energy, that time gamma emission will not be there. Even after the beta emission, still the energy is yet to be lost, then secondary emission will occur. Secondary emission and primary emission, now is it understood? So, these are the first and must. They are accompanied by, followed by, after the alpha or beta, sometimes alpha followed by beta, then it will be parallelly with gamma. Understood? Alpha, gamma plus beta, gamma, like that, they will be after the primary emission only. Understood? So, this is about the third point, primary emission and secondary emission. In the first point, we have studied about the what will be the alpha particle and what will be the clearance with respect to alpha particle. Okay. So, alpha particle will increase the N by P ratio. Okay. Then beta particle will decrease the N by P ratio. Understood? So, likewise, and to gamma particle will emit, will decrease the energy. Okay. Now, third point. Okay. Sorry, fourth point. Before starting the fourth point, there are some terms used in the nuclear chemical reaction. Okay. Here we will not call as a reactant. We will call it as a parent. What we will call it as a parent nucleide. Parent nucleide. And the product formed is called as a daughter. Product formed is called as daughter nucleide. Okay. Daughter nucleide. Is it understood? So, here instead of using, in future whatever I will use as a parent and daughter. That's it, sufficient. Okay. Now, here I will separate them into the four types. Okay. What four types of reactions are there in the fourth point. Understood? Alpha emission, beta emission, gamma emission, alpha and 2-beta emission. Okay. In the fourth point, I am going to take four different cases. What if alpha emission takes place in the reaction wise? In this reaction, I will tell. Understood? Beta emission. What if a parent nucleate loses beta? What is the relation between daughter and parent nucleate?
And what if a parent nucleus emits gamma radiation? What is the relation between daughter and parent? What if alpha and 2 beta are emitted? Okay, so let's start one by one. First, let us take the alpha emission. Let us take about alpha emission. Okay, so an element x loses, element x with atomic number A and mass number, atomic number Z and mass number A, okay, loses a alpha particle. In the nature, I told you types of radioactive radiation. I told you 2 helium 4. Is it understood? 2 helium 4. Then the daughter nuclei, this is a radioactive radiation. Don't consider this. Okay. Now the daughter nuclei, this daughter nuclei will be entirely chemically and nuclear stability will be entirely different from the parent nuclei. Okay. So there is no hereditary principle here which you find in the biology. Daughter will not be no way similar to the parent. Okay. So here this atomic number is going to be reduced by 2 and mass number is going to be reduced by 4 because in the nuclear chemical reaction, balancing is done by the two steps, balancing of atomic numbers, balancing of mass numbers. Balancing of what? Atomic numbers and balancing of mass number. First we will balance what? Atomic numbers. So to balance this, Z and 2 right side, therefore this has to be Z minus 2. And to balance the mass number, here A and here 4, so this mass number will be A minus 4. How to balance the nuclear chemical reaction, is it understood? Now the relation, okay, what is the main importance is relation between X and Y, okay. So I am not asking relation means parent daughter, that is there, okay. But other than this, there is some terms. In first lecture, I have explained you about the some basic terms used in the nuclear chemistry. Like isotope, isobar, like that. Relation between X and Y, I am asking about the relation between X and Y. Okay. So here, first relation between X and Y. If you see this, I clearly mentioned in the first lecture itself. Okay. So, if you are not attended that first lecture, please go through that first lecture, okay, for understanding this, okay. So, these two, the two elements with the two less atomic number, four less mass number are called as isodiaphers. What they are called as? Isodiaphers, okay. Isodiaphers. Isodiaphers means which have same, very good, same isotopic, okay, isotopic excess mass, okay. What is that? Same isotopic excess mass, okay. Two atoms, two nucleus having same isotopic excess mass. What is the isotopic excess mass? Go to the first lecture and there you will find it, okay. So first point, in the fourth point, first, if a parent nucleide loses alpha particle, the daughter and parent are isodiaphers to each other. The daughter nucleide and the parent nucleides are isodiaphers to each other. This fourth point is clear. Fourth A point. Okay. Once you note down this clearly, then we will go for the B point. That is, what if beta emission takes place? Okay, noted this fourth A point. Now we will go for the fourth B point. Okay, we will go for which point? Fourth, but B point. B point is for beta emission. B point is for what? Beta emission. A point was for alpha emission. Okay, so B for the beta emission. Now in the beta emission, same, I will take X element with atomic number Z and mass number A, okay. Then if it loses a beta particle, nature, in the very first alpha, beta, gamma, the before starting this lecture, I have clearly explained the 13 points, okay. How many points? 13 points in the lecture number 3. in lecture number 3 I clearly told alpha particle what is the problem, beta particle what is the nature, gamma particle what is the nature. So there I clearly mentioned minus 1 beta 0. Okay, so to write the Nietzsche reaction, the denoted is very very important. This is the denoting. Okay, so once it is to be minus 1, then atomic number will increases by 1, whereas mass number does not make any difference. Let us take Y. Is it understood? So when a parent nucleide loses beta particle, loses which particle? Beta particle. The daughter nucleide produced, both have same mass number but different atomic number. Same mass number, different atomic number. Technique also I told you, top same. Okay, so then they are called as, what they are called as, see, same atomic number, different, sorry, same atomic, same mass number but different atomic number. Okay, remember. Okay, got this. Let us take 1H1, 1H2 and 1H3. Okay, their top is different, therefore they are called as isotopes. But here top is same. Top is in Sanskrit, weight is called as bar. Okay, in Sanskrit also I told you in that lecture. So they are called as isobars. What they are called as? Isobar. That means beta emission produces a daughter element which is a isobar of the parent nuclei. Okay, so how to write and balance when a beta emission takes place, is it understood? I don't think any problem is there in the beta part. Okay, next coming to the, after the beta, next what is the next one? What is the next one? Very good. C part is gamma. Okay, what is the next part? C part is gamma. Okay, same thing I will take X with atomic number Z, mass number A, loses a gamma. What is the symbol for gamma? 0 and 0. There is no change in the mass number. There is no change in atomic number. That's why I am writing again X. Okay? If there is change in atomic number, then only what I will do? I will write the same different symbol. Once atomic number is same, even mass number is same, then what is these two relation is called as? They are called as nuclear isomers. What they are called as? Nuclear isomers. Okay. So, atoms of same element with same atomic number but same mass number but differing in energy. Out of these we appear both are X only. But this energy will be less than this one. Nuclear energy I am talking about, not complete energy, total energy. I am talking about nuclear energy of X is less than the nuclear energy of this X. So once their nuclear energy is different, they both are called as what? Nuclear isomers. What they are called as? Nuclear isomers. Okay, X and X are called as nuclear isomers, in which daughter nucleus nuclear energy will be less than the parent nucleus nuclear energy. Okay. So, three conditions we have studied and fourth condition is very very special. Okay. So, for what is the fourth condition I told you? Fourth condition I told you, 1 alpha and 2 beta. Okay. 1 alpha and 2 beta. So, let us take same X with atomic number Z, mass number A. Okay. If it loses 1 alpha particle, then it gives a daughter nucleide Y. Okay, so this is going to be Z minus 2 and A minus 4. Okay, then if it loses beta particle, then a Z, let us take P. Okay, so P, don't take it as a phosphorus, understood? So here it will be, atomic number will be increased by 1. With each beta, atomic number increases by 1. But mass number remains same. Okay, then after the beta, one more beta, I told you 2 beta. Okay, so 2 beta, second beta, if it loses, again atomic number increases by 1. So z minus 2 plus 1. This will result in z minus 1. Okay, z minus 1 plus 1 because of this. So it is going to give a new element q. Understood? So with every beta, atomic number increases by 1. Therefore, atomic number will remain as z, but still mass number is a minus 4. So when you compare these two, x and q, directly I will write together. Okay, with one beta, increased z minus 2 to z minus 1, with another beta, z. Okay, so atomic number both are z. Mass number here it is a, and mass number here it is a minus 4. What is the mass number here? A minus 4. So two atoms having same atomic number, they can be written same as not. Okay, same. So that means q and a, we can write it as a same. Okay, sorry, x. We can write them as a x only, because their atomic number and identity of an element is its atomic number. Okay, so they both are same. When they are formed, one alpha particle followed by two beta particle. Okay, so same atomic number but different mass number. They both are called as isotopes. What they are called as? Isotopes. Is it understood? All the four conditions, is it clear? Okay, so to avoid confusion, what I will do, I will write all together. What I will do, I will write all four conditions together, then you can note down this, then it will be easy to understand this. Okay, x element, okay, x element with atomic number z, mass number a. Okay, first condition, alpha. Okay, so what I will write, best method is P, Q, R, S. Don't take this S as a sulfur, don't take this P as a phosphorus. Okay. Oh, okay, first one alpha. Okay, one alpha, if P is produced, then it will be Z minus 2, A minus 4. Okay, here A and P. What I am doing, x and p are isodiaphers. What they are? Isodiaphers. Okay, so any element after loss of one alpha particle, the daughter and parent nucleate relation will be isodiaphers. Okay, now let us take q is formed because of the beta emission. So beta emission will be atomic number increases by 1 but mass number same. So x and q both are called as iso, what their atomic number is increased, isobar. Okay, mass is same, therefore they are called as isobar. Okay. Next, r, if it is r produced, then r produced because of what? Gamma emission. So in R, atomic number also same, mass number also same, even you can write it as X only. Okay, just for differentiating I am writing it as R. Okay, so this X, this R, both are same. Okay, so they are isomers. What they are? Isomer. Okay, next, minus 1 alpha minus 2 beta, consecutively minus 1 alpha plus minus 2 beta. What I written? S. So here atomic number is going to be same. That means X and S symbol will be same. And mass number but reduced by 4. Okay. Same atomic number, different mass number. Therefore X and S, they are called as isotopes. Okay. The fourth point is most important in the theory of nuclear disintegration. Okay. So I think this board is sufficient, but for explanation, if you want, everything is clearly explained. Just to make a note of it. Okay, noted. So this is all about the nuclear disintegration theory. Every point, first we have this explained in the four points, and fourth point is further explained in further four points. I think you liked it. If still not liked, then you have to like it. Understood? And share it to your friends. See you. Bye-bye.